More than 100 people have been pulled from the wreckage here after yesterday's monster tornado, one that left one hospital destroyed with hundreds in need of care. Dr. Sanjay Gupta joins us outside what was once Moore Medical Center. Dr. Gupta, thanks so much for being with us. So that hospital was right in the path of the storm, and looking at the building right now, you would think it would be hard to survive, but they did. How?
Yeah, it's pretty remarkable. And you remember, Jake, we saw something very similar in Joplin as well, where a hospital becomes something that's in the path of the storm. Look, some of it's just fast thinking. Some of it's preparation by people in order to try and make sure patients and staff are safe. Moving, for example, as you have always heard since you were a kid, to the center of the building if you can, to an area that's away from windows. It was fast thinking, I think, and a lot of prep work. But nobody, my understanding, is talking to some of the doctors recently here, Jake. I mean, no one was even injured sort of inside that hospital. And again, you look at that, the top floor is just gone. It's a 45-bed hospital. Many patients were also evacuated after that. And keep in mind, Jake, the situation at that time, there were still storms. There were still concerns about tornadoes at that time. So in addition to trying to get these people to safety, they themselves were putting themselves at risk. So it was a pretty dramatic unfolding situation, Jake.
Dozens of survivors have been hospitalized and more than 200 others have been treated. What types of injuries are we talking about?
You know, when you think about this, and, you know, we've talked about this in the context of other natural disasters, but think about, you know, the primary injury, first of all, just from the force of the tornado itself. You know, now we're hearing winds and sometimes over 200 miles an hour. But then secondary wave of injuries is usually from shrapnel that's going through the air. And I'll just show you, just around me here even, Jake, probably around you as well, there's just debris everywhere. Like, this is something that came off of probably a house, something like this. These all become potential sources of injury, impalements, broken bones. We hear of at least two patients who had significant spinal cord injuries at one of the trauma centers close to here. A bowling ball, for example. We find bowling balls being thrown around. All of this is part of that second wave of injuries. And finally, the third wave, Jake, is when bodies themselves, people themselves, actually going, being thrown against other objects. So those are the types of injuries. What is interesting, and we're going to dig deeper and find out why, thankfully, this happened, there weren't as many brain or head injuries as you'd normally expect, that they even saw back here in 99 when they had a string of tornadoes. I'm not sure why that is, but a little bit of good news there, Jake, perhaps.
All right, Sanjay Gupta, thank you so much.